Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. New data reveal that the interstellar asteroid that recently zipped through our solar system is rocky, cigar-shaped, and has a somewhat reddish hue. It's the first confirmed object from another star observed in our solar system and was discovered October 19th by the University of Hawaii's Pan-STARRS1 telescope team, funded by NASA's Near-Earth Object Observations Program. The telescope team named it Oumuamua, Hawaiian for a messenger from afar arriving first. The unusually shaped asteroid, which is up to a quarter mile long and perhaps 10 times as long as it is wide, may provide new clues into how other solar systems formed.
At liftoff of Delta II and NOAA's Joint Polar Satellite System 1.
NASA and the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration launched NOAA's Joint Polar Satellite System 1, or JPSS-1, from Vandenberg Air Force Base in California on Saturday, November 18th. JPSS-1 is designed to improve the accuracy of weather forecasts out to 7 days, using the most advanced technology NOAA has ever flown in a polar orbiting satellite to capture more precise observations than ever of our atmosphere, land, and waters. Our James Webb Space Telescope recently completed its final phase of cryogenic testing at our Johnson Space Center in Houston, a significant milestone in the telescope's journey to the launch pad. Expected to launch in 2019, Webb will study every phase in the history of our universe, starting with the first luminous glows following the Big Bang. The nearly 100 days of tests inside Johnson's historic Chamber A vacuum facility was designed to ensure the telescope functioned as expected in an extremely cold, airless environment akin to that of space. Dark features on Mars, previously thought to be evidence for subsurface flowing of water, may actually be caused by flowing grains of sand and dust slipping downhill, according to new research published November 20th in the journal Nature Geoscience. These features, called recurring slope lineae, or RSL, have evoked fascination and controversy since their 2011 discovery as possible markers for unexpected liquid water or brine on an otherwise dry planet. Evidence still suggests there are large deposits of water ice under the Martian surface, but not likely at or near the surface of the Red Planet. Astronauts aboard the International Space Station shared a traditional Thanksgiving meal in their unique home away from home.
Got some mashed potatoes, are always good for Thanksgiving. Joe's, I think, got some turkey.
Gotta have some turkey.
Paolo's cornbread dressing. And Sabo's got the candied yams. And so these are all things that remind us a little bit of home and kind of traditional.
Though far away from their families back on Earth, they shared their special meal in an extraordinarily special place.
Happy Thanksgiving!
And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at www.nasa.gov.